Well, you thought you knew all about the Netherlands. Just sit back and we'll show you.
The Netherlands is a very small part of the earth and has almost 70 million inhabitants, a colourful collection of people. There is virtually no other country in the world where you'll find such a variety of nationalities and cultures as in the Netherlands.
For a small country, you have to be inventive. For example, most of our country is reclaimed land. So where I'm going now is 1 meter under the water level.
Whoa!
And the beautiful flat landscape ensures the wind can do its job. That's the reason that the Netherlands is home to enormous wind farms generating energy.
Well, that same wind also costs you a lot of energy. We're trying to cycle against it.
The Dutch are known abroad as an open-minded, tolerant nation with an entrepreneurial spirit.
As you can see, we try to sell you everything. But then, as the Dutch, we have a lot to offer.
In Going Dutch, I'll take you along on a voyage of discovery through the Netherlands. Michiel de Ruiter, Piet Hein, Abel Tasman are just some of our nautical heroes who sailed on ships like these and discovered the world.
At the beginning of the 17th century, the Dutch East India Company became increasingly powerful. It was the beginning of the golden age for the former Kingdom of the Netherlands. It was an age in which trade, science and the arts flourished. The relatively small Netherlands landed on many a shore around the globe in that period. Suriname, Indonesia, South Africa, and the Netherlands Antilles. Even New York was once called New Amsterdam and was home to many windmills.
Exactly these kinds of chaps. And here at the Zaanse Schans you go back in time. And you can see how the Netherlands was during that golden age.
The Netherlands flourished in the 17th century like never before. And at that time, the Zaanstreek was the industrial zone of the world. It formed the basis for Verkade chocolate, Albert Heijn supermarkets and the Dovis nut production. The windmills on the Zaanse Schans are still in use. They are used for industries like sawing timber and grinding raw materials for the paint industry.
Wat doet daar een molenaar eigenlijk?
De molenaar is in eerste instantie verantwoordelijk voor een officieel Nederlands Rijksmonument. Het is een vrij bijzondere molen, omdat het de enigste werkende verfmolen is ter wereld. Ja. He, dus dat is natuurlijk heel aardig dat je aan de ene kant sta je gewoon commercieel in 2013. Ja. Aan de andere kant natuurlijk omgeven met een wolk van nostalgie. Ja.
The oldest houses on the Zaanse Schans are still inhabited. And there are a number of old traditional Dutch trades you can still admire, like making cheese and chocolate, casting tin, brewing spirits and manufacturing clocks.
These are the types of clocks you're used to seeing. But look at this new design, clock 2.0.
And there are two occasions in which the whole country will turn orange. First is King's Day, and second is a special sport event like this, football.
The Netherlands is a real sporting country. Many international sport events are organized here, and there are three sports in which the Dutch excel: football, field hockey, and speed ice skating. At least, if you base it on results.
There are also typical Dutch sports, like korfball or fieldjeppen, ditch vaulting. I heard it's not very easy, so wish me luck.
Yeah. But football is still the most popular sport by far.
Young and old, everyone can play football in the Netherlands. Well, almost everyone. And women's football has been given a tremendous boost in the recent years.
Hoe belangrijk is dat er geïnvesteerd wordt in de jeugdopleiding?
Nederland kan zich alleen maar meten met de rest van de wereld als wij talenten goed ontwikkelen. En wij hebben inderdaad 1 miljoen voetballende spelers, maar het buitenland heeft er natuurlijk veel meer. Ja. Duitsland is ietsje groter bijvoorbeeld, en Spanje ook. Dus de keus is daar groter als bij ons. Dus wij moeten het hebben van een goede jeugdopleiding, van een goede trainersopleiding ook. Ja. En gelukkig hebben wij die.
To this day, the Dutch football system is internationally revered. Players like Cruyff, Van Basten and Bergkamp have earned their place among the all-time greats. There's nothing that unites the Dutch more than football. As soon as the Dutch national team comes into action, 17 million citizens rush to the pubs in their orange shirts. It's usually worth it since the national team goes far in most tournaments.
Hoe belangrijk is het nou dat het Nederlands publiek, dat oranje gevoel?
Het is natuurlijk fantastisch dat we zo'n mooi legioen hebben. Ja. En, ik heb heel veel grote toernooien meegemaakt, heel veel wedstrijden mogen spelen op het Nederlands elftal. Alleen, ja, oranje is echt een herkenbare kleur. Ja. Dus overal waar je komt, je ziet gelijk waar de supporters zijn. Zoals bijvoorbeeld hier of in de Kuip een heel stadion oranje. Ja, dat geeft zo'n kickgevoel, waardoor je eigenlijk niet slecht kan spelen.
Doesn't matter how good or how bad we play, we always have the support of our Dutch supporters. Go Holland!
With regards to art, the Netherlands is particularly famous for its great masters like Rembrandt and Van Gogh. But we have much more to offer. What about Rietveld's designs or Berlage's architecture? And, for example, Anton Corbijn.
And how cool is it that every superstar wants you to take their photo?
But there are many more Dutch artists that enjoy international success. Whether it's in the fashion industry, design or architecture.
And this is the perfect place if you want to see a little bit more of this Dutch art. The Royal Concert Hall and 3 other prominent museums all within easy reach of this museumplein.
Besides the Stedelijk and the Rijksmuseum, you can find the Van Gogh Museum here. In this museum you can admire the largest collections of the Netherlands' best known painter, Vincent van Gogh. With 1.5 million visitors a year, it is one of the most popular museums in the Netherlands.
Many of our Vincent masterpieces are on display in this museum, and it's very interesting to see how his work developed over the years. What makes him such an extraordinary artist?
Well, I think it's really a multitude of aspects. He was, you know, a talented artist. I mean, he taught himself in a very short period of time. I mean, he was only active as an artist for 10 years and he only painted for about 8.
Oh, right.
So that's one of the amazing things. His paintings have become icons because I guess they speak still to our imagination. They're colorful, they show everyday subjects, you know, everything that we can relate to very easily.
Why do you think the people in that time didn't see that?
Yeah, it's difficult to say, really. I guess Van Gogh was a bit ahead of his time, and somehow people didn't quite recognize also the novelty in his work. That happens more often to artists.
I find it sometimes hard to believe that he only was able to sell one painting in his entire life, even though his brother was an art dealer, wasn't he?
It's true. His brother Theo was an art dealer and still couldn't sell his work.
It is simply unbelievable that he managed to sell only one of his paintings whilst he was still alive. And that is one of my personal favorites.
Luke, this is something I'm particularly proud of as a Dutch native. A modern version of our most popular means of transportation.
Dutch manufacturers spend a lot of energy designing and manufacturing high-quality, innovative products. Philips is a prime example with the invention of the light bulb, tape cassette and the CD. But the Netherlands also makes its mark in many other fields, like for example, Spyker cars, Van Bommel shoes, TomTom navigation and Bols Genevas.
This is a typical Dutch drink, Genever, from an age-old Dutch brand, Bols.
Bols is the world's oldest distilled spirit brand and dates back to 1575. Geneva is made according to a traditional recipe of soft grain distillates and herbs and can only be produced in the Netherlands and a few neighboring provinces.
Bols, Geneva and liquors are still made according to age-old recipes of past master distillers.
Founder of the company, Lucas Bols, had shares in the Dutch East India Company. He had access to a vast array of new herbs and spices from the East and incorporated these into more than 300 different liquors and his Geneva.
An interesting fact is that Lucas Bols and Rembrandt were good friends and that Rembrandt sometimes used these same herbs to create his colorful paint. What a small world after all.
In the House of Bols Cocktails and Geneva Experience in Amsterdam, you can experience the rich history and all the tastes of Bols itself. Nowadays, this brand produces 38 liquors, which are exported to more than 100 countries and used in numerous cocktails.
One watermelon Cosmo, please. Wat inspireert je nou bij het maken van een goede cocktail?
Allereerst de mensen natuurlijk. Het gaat altijd helemaal om je gasten. Dus iedereen die aan je bar staat, ja, kan er vertellen wat ze lekker vinden. En dan ga je dan mee aan de slag.
Ik moet zeggen, als je cocktails net zo goed zijn als jij die flesje gooit, dan is dat wel goed op.
Ja, nou, ik doe mijn best.
Very nice. And of course you can drink Geneva in the old-fashioned Dutch way. With a slurp. Cheers.
The story of the boy who saved our country by putting his finger in the dike might not be fact, but it is a fact that we've battled with the waters for years upon years.
And that has led to enormous projects. After the North Sea flood of 1953, these delta works were built. And what about the Afsluit Dijk, an enclosure dam with a length of 32 kilometers? It's not a coincidence that the Dutch are frequently involved in large water projects around the world.
Well, it's for good reason that Rotterdam is still the largest port in Europe.
It's difficult to imagine, but more than half of the Dutch live under sea level. The dams, dunes and locks protect the land from the water. But that doesn't happen all by itself. Thousands of people work daily at maintaining the height and strength of the Dutch flood defences.
Nou, de zeespiegel stijgt.
Ja, dat is een feit.
En maar wat doen we daaraan als land?
Nederland ligt aan de Noordzee en de Noordzee stijgt, maar het land zakt.
Oh ja?
Dus het zijn nog twee bewegingen tegelijkertijd. Dus we houden wat dat betreft rekening met dat je in een eeuw misschien wel een meter of anderhalve meter extra hoogteverschil moet overwinnen. En wat we doen is natuurlijk onze dijken op orde houden, ja. Onze pompcapaciteit, de gemalen op orde houden. En zorgen dat we voldoende energie hebben om 24/7 te blijven pompen.
And of course, all that water offers us plenty of opportunity for recreation and water sports.
Being a country at the sea, fish has always been an important part of our diet. And actually, it's one particular fish the Dutch all love, the herring. Hey.
Hallo.
Wat een haantje van jou?
Eikzuur.
Lekker.
Best sushi in town.
Dutch cuisine is very diverse. Many products are traditionally cultivated here, like potatoes, fish and vegetables. You can find them in both traditional and haute cuisine dishes. The combination of a colonial past and a multicultural society ensures that exotic dishes can be found everywhere.
We Dutch sometimes get the strange nickname of cheese hat. Well, what the heck? We're expert in making cheese.
The process of making cheese has been perfected over the centuries. Although the whole world demands our young Dutch export cheese, we have a much larger selection to offer.
Leo, wat maakt deze kaas nou zo bijzonder? Het bijzondere aan deze kaas ligt in het feit dat ze ambachtelijk gemaakt worden. De rommel wordt in open draineerbakken, net als vroeger bij de boer, de kaas gemaakt werd. Zo wordt deze kaas ook gemaakt.
Oh, goed.
We staan in een natuurpakhuis, maar door de wisseling van temperatuur krijgt die kaas een hele, in dimensie, een hele fijne smaak.
It's the long natural maturation that gives the Rijpenaar cheese its character. You can go to the special Rijpenaar tasting room in Amsterdam to learn to properly judge and experience it.
Veel mensen lekker vinden, maar maak die kaas even gevaarlijk.
En waar moet ik nou op letten?
Nou, je moet hem niet meteen in je mond stoppen. Je moet hem even onder je neus houden en dan die geuren oppakken van die kaas.
Ruikt lekker.
Ja, dat is toch een beleving van kaas.
Het komt hier een beetje achterin.
Dat is de beleving al van kaas voordat je hem gaat eten. En dan ga je hem eten en dan is de smaak totaal anders dan je geur.
I have to say, it's a shame they didn't invent Taste TV, because this is the height of Dutch delight. Moet je zelf niet even...
Look, all these containers are used for export.
The Netherlands may be a small country in terms of surface area, but the country is in the top 10 of the largest exporters worldwide. Key sectors are agriculture and food, horticulture and the chemical industry. Trade is what flows through a Dutch person's veins, and globally, you'll find the Dutch in key positions everywhere. And there are also many successful large Dutch companies in the international area.
A good example of the Dutch international business character you find here at the Zuidas.
The Zuidas is the business district of Amsterdam. The area is easily accessible, located only 7 minutes from Schiphol International Airport. Due to the many locals and expats that live and work here, this is a vibrant place with large companies, complemented with an array of bars and restaurants.
Waarom is Nederland een aantrekkelijk land om, om je onderneming te beginnen?
Niet alleen financieel, dus voor tax redenen. Maar ook omdat alles klein is in verhouding tot andere landen. Dus je kan snel op andere plekken komen.
En merk je dan ook dat je, omdat je juist hier op de Zuidas zit, dat het helpt dat er zoveel internationale mensen werken?
Ja, absoluut. Plus het is gewoon een ontzettend leuke plek om je bedrijf te starten. Want de vibe die je hier vindt. Ja, dat vind je niet in de stad.
Want omschrijf je hier vibe eens even?
Nou, weet je, het mooie denk ik vind ik van de locatie. Weet je, het zijn allemaal ondernemers. Iedereen die wil succesvol zijn. Iedereen werkt hard, maar kan ook daarna veel plezier maken. Je ontmoet een heleboel leuke verschillende mensen en bedrijven.
Ja.
Maar ook het feit dat wij 1 treinstop van Schiphol zitten.
Ja.
Dus in 7 minuten kunnen klanten, bezoekers, collega's kunnen hier komen.
People across the globe particularly like to do business with the Dutch.
What's a typical characteristic of the Dutch people?
On time.
On time? Oh,
on
really?
Time.
I'm always too late.
You may be an exception. I come from the south, but usually for business they are on time.
Oh, really good.
Specific. Very direct. When a problem is a problem, you don't have to turn around the kettle.
Ze hebben juist de attitude. Ze houden van bouwen. No nonsense. Eerlijk. En iets opzetten met z'n allen.
Ja, mooi. Nou, op de zaak.
Dankjewel. Dankjewel voor het.
To experience a concert in this royal concertgebouw is truly special. It breathes nostalgia.
This impressive building dates back to the end of the 19th century and has lots of elegant details. The program varies and ranges from classical to pop. The Royal Concertgebouw attracts about 700,000 visitors every year.
Wat bijzonder dat je hier mag dirigeren. Ik heb begrepen dat het een heel bijzonder concertgebouw is.
Nou, het concertgebouw is inderdaad heel erg bijzonder. Dat heeft te maken met zijn akoestiek. Je hoort het al als ik praat. Het is heel duidelijk te verstaan. Het articuleert heel precies. Je hebt een beetje nagal, maar niet te lang. Er was één keer een orkest wat ik dirigeerde uit Oostenrijk. En daarmee gingen we een heel tournee maken. Niet alleen in Oostenrijk gaven concerten, ook in Italië en in Duitsland. En het eind van het hele tournee waren we hier in Amsterdam in het concertgebouw. We gingen repeteren. De klankrepetitie voor het concert begint, om even te weten hoe is het hier. Was het net alsof er een bepaalde spanning in het orkest kwam. Van iedereen voelde een beetje zijn maag kriebelen, bij mij ook. Maar een hele goede spanning, een spanning van...
Het is echt een magische plek eigenlijk.
Het is een magische plek.
When you walk through this building, you see one beautiful detail after the other. And one particularly funny detail, I think, is that number 63 is the chair of the king. I'm gonna think I will sit here. Speaking of music, the Dutch DJs have made their mark internationally in the past decade. And this is why.
With famous DJs like Armin van Buuren, Tiësto and Hardwell, the Netherlands also does particularly well in the dance scene. The Netherlands is also at the forefront when it comes to festivals and events. These sensation events, for example, have been highly successful internationally.
Nederland is natuurlijk super populair op het gebied van DJ's.
Ja.
Wat is nou het geheim?
Ik denk dat het er toch in zit dat wij vrij vroeg, daar waar Amerika al nog bezig was met R&B en hip-hop, dat wij heel vroeg zijn begonnen met dancemuziek. En dancemuziek is nu eigenlijk pas opkomend in Amerika. Nu wordt het groot in Amerika. En als je ook kijkt naar de DJ's die de wereld overgaan, zoals Armin, Fedde, Afrojack, ja, dat is bijna een top exportproduct van ons geworden.
Ja, klopt.
As you can see, this small country with almost 17 million inhabitants has a whole lot to offer.
There is so much more that we could show you. I just hope that this has inspired you to come and to see for yourself what the Netherlands has to offer. Tot ziens.